Yes, M3 platform. It is meant for all mompreneurs. There is nothing to prepare at all. We have joined this just to share our thoughts with all our colleagues, with all our dear friends, with all the lovely moms over here. You know, that is the beauty of M3, which is absolutely different from the other platforms.
As we all know, this month the topic which has been given is imagination. And as a mother, as an educator, I have always connected to this word. And since I started my teaching career with pre-primary students as a Montessori teacher, I know all the aspects of this imagination. So let me tell you a story. That time I was a class teacher of the first graders, and I thought, why not make maths a little more interesting? And when I was just turning out the pages, I saw there are sums where they were counting of sheep and all those things. So I went to the class, I asked them to open the book, and then I told them, just imagine that we are all by the side of a nice river, and water is flowing, and there is nice grassland on the bank of the river, and there are sheep over there. And then I continued with the sum. I wrote the problem on the board, and I taught maybe a couple of sums ahead also. We did sums on counting fishes. And sometime towards the end of my lecture, I found a child sitting without any expression on the face. So I went there, I touched him, and I said, "Are you listening to me? Did you understand the problems?" He was blank. So I called him and I made him sit in the staff room, and I told him, "Why don't you write down what happened during the class?" So this first grader wrote a nice story, but the story starts with that grassland, that river, and then there was no sum in it. There was no maths problem. So it showed that I initiated the process of imagination, and then I could not lead him to where I wanted to. He led himself to some other world, and he created a story out of it. And he only came out of that world when I actually touched him. So this is the power of imagination. This is how we, every individual, are capable of creating an imagery, a picture inside our mind, and God knows where we can take ourselves to. As you all know, this is the story of my heart, that when I wrote the book, Me, Myself, Mom, I wanted this to be a bigger platform. It was there in my imagination. I created the imagery, and today you are there. I was not knowing any one of you before. Each one of you was just a face without any name. But today, the names are increasing, and I feel that if I can make it, everyone can make it. This is how it has happened to me. So, how you create imagination in your life? What is your experience, and what you have to say? Today, I want to know from you.
How nice, Harpreet. You actually, I think you have stolen my word, visualization. Actually, and which is I am practicing these days, to be honest. Somebody said to read the book, The Secret by Rhonda Byrne. Same book, I've been reading. We have been practicing. Me, my daughters, we all three are practicing this, and it's been now 6 to 8 months, and it's a great journey so far. Visualization is nothing but law of attraction. What you imagine, what you visualize, you get in abundance, actually. If you are, if you're throwing, for example, people say that whatever you send to the universe, you get back the same, actually. So similarly, whatever you visualize or imagine, you get back. Whether you are imagining the negativity in your life or you're imagining the positivity, believe me, you get the same. And believe me, this is what I wanted to share today. Ms. Sarvari has already spoken about it. So I'll just share. I think most of you know that I've been following natural Buddhism practice for last 12 years now. and I follow Dr. Daituka Ikeda. He is a mentor to me, and I read his books only, to be honest. But this book was also, The Secret was also shared by one of my very closest friends. So she told me that where you are practicing Nichiren Buddhism, start practicing the gratitude and start doing the law of attraction as well. Visualize positivity, visualize abundance, visualize happiness in your life, and you will get only happiness in your life.
These topics actually help all of us to, you know, brainstorm our knowledge, and it gives us a lot of things to share. So before I start the topic about imagination, I would exactly want to share you what exactly is imagination all about. Basically, according to me, imagination is an ability. It's a form of mental images, if I talk about analogs or narratives, whatever we are keep on thinking in our mind. Like if I talk about an example, you are smelling a lemon without, eating a lemon. You are smelling a fruit without even having it with you. So it's actually, you have to have a very, very, very strong, powerful visualization. The way Dr. Ravi has just said, that will actually help us to connect our past and construct our hypothetical future. And we can make a lot of, future scenarios, which is not with us, but yes, we can make it exist with us, which actually will help us to grow with our professional way, as well as personal way, as well as a human. You can grow much better by imagining something which if you say someone, people can make fun of it. How can you can imagine such a weird thing? But if you keep on, doing this practice every day, trust me, it happens. Because I will tell one of my story. It's a long time back when I was in my, college, and I was always, because in my school, I was a head girl. So I had that much, leadership inside me. How can somebody can replace me? And how can my, senior professor in science can, ask this guy to be the, heading this thing. So I was very, very, very much upset. Then I started, dreaming about it. And I started telling everyone, tomorrow they are going to select me as the head, girl of the college, and tomorrow I'm going to lead it. Everybody was saying, how come is it possible already? Shobhik was the, he was my classmate. His name is already announced 2 days before. And I go, no, it's not. And I was lying there. But I was imagining that tomorrow my name is going to be announced. And you won't believe, it has happened on the day. Suddenly my professors, all of them were there, and suddenly they announced that Shobhik is going to lead. But you know what? We have found Devjani, and she has already done these things in past, and he has already shown us a beautiful project which we are going to, put in this college fest. So this is something out of the world, and we are taking her. Everybody was saying, when you have submitted that? I have submitted it 1 month back. I don't know how come they have selected overnight. So from that time, I started believing ki bhai pehle jhoot bol do, and then started dreaming it. And you won't believe I practice this in my regular life.
You gave me all the reasons to smile, because occult sciences is my very, very dear topic. Good evening, everybody. And I think I'm talking to Dr. Rabia and Dr. Negi since long over messages, LinkedIn messages and all. It's an opportunity to meet both of them personally here. And yes, I'm smiling because I was very happy to hear all the views of everybody for imagination, creativity. So in continuation, what people have shared here, actually, I have been practicing occult sciences at global level now. And being a spiritual healer, I would like to contribute that when you talk about creativity and when you talk about imagination, clearing your own aura before imagining or visualization can only bring your imagination into reality. And when you allow yourself, lot many times, there are lot many mental issues, or there are social issues, there are emotional issues when we go through. And I completely resonate with everybody here that many times it is even difficult to forgive and forget. But believe me, that's the first step of creation and visualization. And I would like to create a say here which I always use as an affirmation. When you feel that you want to forgive something, it could be a place, it could be a person, it could be a situation, it could be a moment, your ex-employer, your ex-colleague, your friend, you know, your partners, because at global level, when we work with people from different countries, you know, being a partner, soulmate connections is a very, very common issue there. So you can seek power to forgive. Because, you know, when your heart is very much affected and when you're not able to heal your heart chakras, we all have chakras in our body. And when you are not able to heal, you seek power to heal. And that's the first step that you create for yourself. You create that space for yourself to come back into your own self. So when you seek power to forgive the other person, the situation, the place, or those moments which did not give you that much of expected, you know, memory, pleasure, or the reciprocation, you forgive the situation, the person, and then you forgive yourself, that being a soul within inside, you gave that pain to yourself. And when you follow the practice of forgiveness for, let's say, 15, 20 days, then you create the power of imagination and then you create the power of visualization.
Good evening, everybody. My field of work is only imagination. Creativity, I believe, are the wings to an imagination. So I belong to the world of fashion, and without imagination, nothing beautiful can come out and no product can ever be established. Imaginations, the beauty of imaginations is that it is totally out of context. It has its own wings and it has its own freedom to fly, and it makes you live a life which probably you cannot or you may not. So that's the beauty of imagination. But I was definitely mesmerized with Dr. Sunita's interpretation of imaginations and how imaginations can be constructed into creativity and things forward. It's a very beautiful thing. So we all know that our mind is an open book. Whatever we imagine, whatever we scribble over there, that is what takes us forward and makes us do things to achieve whatever we are scribbling in our open mind. So this is why people say that it has to, your imaginations has to be very constructive, because only then you are going to achieve or attempt to achieve your imagination and convert it into reality. Somewhere I say that, you know, whatever you imagine, you start dreaming, and then the dreams you start converting into reality. So one, I would say that, you know, once upon a time, I imagined that I would be leading a company and I worked for it. And today, I mean, rest is history, I can say. So, you know, imaginations are so beautiful. I feel like, you know, everybody should just think for a minute in their hectic schedule, entire 24 hours, and they just should be silent. You know, probably imaginations also is powered by meditation and all that even. But whatever it is, if we just think through, if we just, you know, sit down and imagine I'm having an ice cream right now, and we suddenly start feeling that, wow, we had a moment, and then we feel energized to pick up other tasks and all that, you know, like, keep telling a lot of people that you think that I am some chota bacha with a lollipop and you can satisfy me with me all these statuses and all that. So that's what I say a lot of people. But then, you know, this is where the beauty of imagination is. It makes you feel a lot younger, childish. You can imagine yourself to be playing football in the rain, and you suddenly feel that rush of doing new things, new stuff and all that. So I would say that, but yes, definitely, imaginations are also a reflection of your personality. That is something we always should have in our mind. So if we are imagining that we are screwing up someone's life, that's what you are. And that's what we have to think through that, what is that we are imagining. And this is where I think Dr. Sunita was saying, you know, imagination also has a definition, also has a meaning, and it carries a big purpose in our life. So for me, in and out, I believe that imaginations lead to creativity. And the more beautiful things you like to create, the more beautiful your imagination would be. But definitely giving time to realize your imagination and to construct something beautiful out of it is what is being called wise as well.
So what I believe in, I will share that. I believe in a very small phrase from our sacred Vedas of Hindu culture, which says, yad bhav tad bhavati. I often speak about this, yad bhav tad bhavati, which means that you are what you believe and you become as you think. So for me, it is very important that your thoughts, your words, your actions, your deeds are in sync with each other. So when we do that, our imagination process becomes much more smoother, because we all know, we all have spoken about the law of attraction. Dr. Sunita spoke very well about the karmalogy, that how our karmas, we can manifest things, we can visualize things, but for that, we have to be in sync. We have to speak that, we have to think that, and we have to do that. It cannot happen that we are just sitting and visualizing and not working for it. So for me as an educator, I think the moment I see my pre-primary child, a three-year-old child entering the school, I visualize the process of metamorphosis. I visualize that how these small caterpillar will then turn into butterfly when they will leave the institution and go, an entire universe will be there to welcome them. And trust me, till now, whichever bats have passed, like wherein I was there with my students, I have seen them succeeding in the global arena. So visualization is not just for me. I visualize it for all my students, because I feel every time I get a new child in the school, they are like the blank canvas. And then that blank canvas is my masterpiece. We are only visualizing, imagining, and seeing the beautiful world, okay? And we are not working out for that. Then I think the divine will not send it to us. Maybe some few people are so lucky that divine will send that back, but that will definitely take a lot of time. So imagine, because we as human have the capacity and power to imagine. And how beautiful is this world if we keep on imagining about the well-being of each other. Miss Sangeeta imagined about a fabric which is water resistant, and it was not just for her. You see, so it is my personal experience, when we imagine for, say, societal well-being, when we imagine for a bigger goal, we get it soon. The divine is always ready to give it back. So we are not just confined to our own self, but we are thinking about the larger community. And as Dr. Sunita said, the power of forgiveness. I think if we all can practice that, then the world will become a beautiful place. So rather than power of this forgiveness, I just say cheers to criticism. That is a tagline that I use.
Good evening. I was just hearing the beautiful conversation of all these ladies. They are so learned. I'm so happy to be a part, and I joined this one. I'm so happy, and I have learned a lot. And this imagination, it really works for me, because from a shy person, from an introvert person, I have come out in this COVID-19, and I believe in the power of universe, and I really believe it. I should say I have grown in all the four fields, like whether it is health, I have lost 5 kgs, whether it is my relationship, I have very strong relationship, and I can, because today I'm here because of this relationship, because of the universe, I'm making new connections, new love and connections, and I'm so happy. And the third one, career also, like I have, what I have imagined, I got it, like I am prospering. And if I talk about my finances also, I have grown. And it is because of this power of imagination, which I learned very late. That is my, I really regret. And I see talking all these beautiful ladies, like how they have used it right from a young age, like Devjani just now, she said, like started from the time when she was a head girl and she became it. But I realized it last year in COVID-19, it taught me many things. And I do a very this thing, the forgiveness, like just now, Dr. I think Ms. Tank, she said, you know, like about the forgiveness. Of course, I also do it, you know, it's a Ho'oponopono prayer. And the power of imagination has really brought me here today to this platform. And I'm so happy, Sharbari, like you have given me this opportunity to talk here. I was not prepared. I just talked whatever I felt. Thank you so much. And thank you, everybody. And I'm going to use the technique told by Devjani.
Why always tensions are there, stress is there, depression is there? Why can't we imagine a world which is free of all this, you know, all flowers, all birds, all animals, and all of us, you know, sitting in the garden, sipping coffee, reading books, newspapers, and chit-chatting, you know, why can't we imagine that life when there is no stress? Is it necessary to bring all tension in your life? Is it necessary to discuss all these calamities of life? Can't we imagine a life, you know, when there is no tension, when everybody gives my time, me time, pamper yourself, forget about everything. Imagine a life with only all mompreneurs around. Is it necessary that every time we need to discuss or think only of the family, only of our responsibilities and everything? Can't we live a single day, a single life of only me, myself? Pamper yourself, a life which is, you know, devoid of all these things. Give one day to yourself. Imagine a life when there is nobody else, only you. And what are the things which you have not done throughout? What are the priorities of your life? Because we always feel that, you know, everybody is important in the family. Everybody is important, but we are not important. We always, you know, keep us at the last priority. Let me complete everybody else's work, and I will be, you know, taking care of me only at the end when everything is complete. Why? So I imagine a life only for once, that yes, Shelly all around, pamper yourself, do whatever you want to do. And then, you know, imagine that yes, the world is asking me, Shelly, what do you want?